BigSweetRoadRuda.com with your morning horn of Z's, your sip of coffee. Your last sip of coffee. All right, we got great news. Bitcoin over 10,000. Woo-hoo-hoo. That's great. It's gone over 10,000. Yes, there has been a lot of manipulation. A good 10,000 is a good pause place to kind of regain our sanity. And I hate it when the cryptos run up so high. So don't like pray for 12, 14, 16,000. This is great. Because that's when people get in and then they slam it down and reap their rewards. So if we pause around here for a little bit, I'll be really happy. But 10,000 is a big marker. I'm hoping it'll pause for a while, bounce around for a little bit, and then continue to run. If it keeps running and keeps running, people start piling in, and then they set it up for a big slam down to make money on both sides, going up and going down. So, yeah, I'll be talking about that down in Anarchapoco, price rigging on these criminal exchanges. They are absolutely criminal. Just look at the volumes. I mean, circulating supply for Bitcoin is 18 million. Market cap, 182 million. Volume in the last 24 hours, 182 billion, 35 billion just in the past 24 hours. That's unsustainable. That's, you know, every 6 days, every single Litecoin or Bitcoin's ever been traded will have been traded. And I know you guys are used to volume. You think liquidity is great, especially the traders. Liquidity is not great. Liquidity is great if it's real liquidity. Actual Bitcoin being traded, transactions being settled, as in they put it in your name, in your account, and it's pulled off. We don't have that anymore. And with all the futures and options and all the exchanges are rehypothecated. They work off a fractional reserve system. So none of the exchanges hold everything their clients hold in that exchange. So it's really scary. It should be scary. Of course, the biggest offender would be Tether. Look at the volume of Tether in the last 24 hours. $43 billion worth of Tether has traded hands when there's only $4.6 billion worth of Tether that are out there. So clearly that's how they drive things up, drive things down. It's a fractional reserve system. And everybody knows it, but they don't understand the power of price manipulation when you can say, yeah, I'll buy this and not really have anything behind that Tether. But that's how it's done. That's how the game is played. It's played on the stock market, the bond market, obviously the gold and silver markets, and it'll remain that way. Now, a lot of people say, hey, what's wrong with that, Bix? It's a free market. You can do what you want. I agree 100%. I do not think we should have any regulators. But I also think people should lose when they place a losing bet with a criminal exchange. They need to know that it's criminal. They need to understand it. So my job that I've given myself is to educate people that these exchanges are not playing fairly. And as long as you know that and you choose to participate in it, especially when things like Mt. Gox or Quadriga CX or any of the exchanges go down that claim they were hacked, they weren't hacked. They never had the coins to start with. Just keep that in mind when you're out there trading and keeping your coins in exchanges or online brokerage houses, things like that. They're not playing a fair game. So what you can do to beat them at their game is to buy the coins, trade the coins, pull them off the exchanges, keep them in your own wallet where you own the private keys. It's that simple. And on that note, check out this article I just read on Zero Hedge, don't get juice jacked while recharging in public, cybersecurity expert warns. So plugging into free charging stations, they can take all your information off your phone just by plugging it into these charging stations. It's crazy. Here's the article. Do you plug your phone into free public charging stations? Be careful. According to NBC News, you may get juice jacked by hijackers who have installed malware that can tunnel and copy your sensitive personal information. If you keep your cryptos on your phone, that's not a good idea either. It's coming down to cryptos are going to be so valuable that everybody and their mother is going to try to steal them. And Little did you know, by going to a charging station at the airport and plugging in your phone, it's taking all your data out of your phone. That's crazy. So important to learn how to store your cryptos properly. Hardware wallets, yes, absolutely. Paper wallets made properly, yes, absolutely. Just look into it, dive deep, take a deep dive. If you're going to be involved with cryptos, you need to fully understand all the ways to protect yourself. All right. Of course, if you're looking for a store of value, there's always silver. And silver and gold are better stores of value than Bitcoin. I said it. Silver and gold are better stores of value than Bitcoin. Why? Because if you have the physical thing and you're sure you have it, you're the one trying to protect it. No one's going to, plug their phone into into a charging station at the airport and steal your silver and gold unless you have a third party holding it. So right now, at least, I think if you're looking just for safety and store value, I go with silver and gold, and obviously the gold-silver ratio is all mixed up. It's at 88 to 1, which is ridiculous. Okay, I did an interview yesterday with my friend Andy Scheckman. He's been in the business over 25 years at Miles Franklin. He knows exactly what he's doing. He has offered to meet any price that the Road to Ruta people, guys, you watching this video, contact if you want to get some silver, which is highly recommended, or gold, which is, gold is good, but it's no silver. It's a different story. call Andy and watch this video. I posted it yesterday. It's called Alert Urgent Silver Information. Andy goes through what's going on in the silver market, why it's so important right now, and why silver is so cheap. And then he offers a personal, literally a gift to Road to Ruta people watching this. All you have to do is email him, andy@milesfranklin.com. We go over what he's going to offer, and he's going to match any price of silver for a little bit, at least a week. So if you're looking to get some silver and you don't have any yet, you're looking for safety and a store of value, silver, you can't beat it. Yeah, gold's okay, but there's massive amounts of gold. Silver to gold ratio at 88 to 1 is a gift. Even if you want to buy gold now, you're probably better off buying silver until the ratio goes down, and it will go down. It always does, especially on the rises. I think it'll go down to 10 to 1. If it goes down to 10 to 1, you're going to get 8 times as much gold by buying silver now and then swapping it into gold. Anyway, watch the video and then contact Andy Scheckman at Miles Franklin. Email andy@milesfranklin.com. Yes, he says he's got a hell of a lot of emails from Road to Ruta people from the interview yesterday. Watch the interview because it makes sense. And Andy knows this stuff, and you have to trust who you're going to buy silver with, just as you have to trust who you're going to buy your cryptos with. So, and I fully trust Andy. So give him a call, talk to him, and see what he can do for you. All right. And there's his contact. You can go to milesfranklin.com, but they're not an online store. If you believe in it, there's too many fakes. And now is the time. As silver starts to run, you're going to see a lot of these online stores go out of business, because they don't have the silver that they tell their customers. It happens every time. So, it'll be 2 weeks for delivery. Oh, well, it looks like a 3 week. It looks like 4 week. And nobody can find the silver. So you got to go with someone you trust. I fully trust Andy. Give him a call. All right. And where is silver? Completely held down this week because of the Trump victory lap, the Trump bump, as I call it. So it's still under 18 bucks. Screaming buy. Not to mention Soft announced that JP Morgan is the company is under investigation for precious metals manipulation, has been for 2 years. Really interesting concept, because I question whether or not they would be under investigation. Any of this would have happened if Blythe Masters and Jamie Dimon did not snag all the physical off the market and just played the short game like they've been playing for the riggers they've been playing for at least 50 years, since Greenspan invented the first computer programs to rig the markets. But JP Morgan kind of outsmarted the riggers, and not only did they suppress the price with COMEX shorts, they took the physical. And that's even a great excuse that, I had to hedge my physical so So they can keep the price the same, get as much physical as they want, and then get out of the physical short. That's the question, how they get out of it. And you've got seven other dumb banks who thought the game was still on. I think that's why the Department of Justice is going after Jamie Dimon, because he's about to destroy the rigging mechanism, potentially. The other potential is what Jim Woolley's been saying. Andy Shechtman said it. It is possible that JP Morgan is buying gold and silver for China, which is a huge fight with the U.S. government right now. China and the U.S. are fighting over everything. If it is true, that's even a bigger reason for the DOJ to go after JP Morgan, Jamie Dimon, Blythe Masters. They'll probably call it treason. It's not in the interest of the United States. So hang on to your silver, my friends. It's going to get crazy. And speaking of getting crazy, this article came out in the New York Times, the money behind Trump's money about Deutsche Bank. This may be the next ploy for the Democrats, is to go after Deutsche Bank for all their dealings with Trump over the years. Taking Deutsche Bank out would crash the economy. A crashed economy has everybody pointing at the rich, and the Democrats have a shot at their socialist agenda. So keep an eye on this. I think it's the next thing. I don't think they'll go for impeachment again. I think they'll go for something related to crashing the economy. And if they do that, wow. And it can. It's not that easy to crash a manipulated economy. All you got to do is, for example, have someone buy all the silver. Michael Bloomberg could become president. If he stops putting his billions towards radio and TV ads and starts putting it towards physical silver, he could probably win the election because the economy would seize up. It's that fragile. Interesting times. Keep an eye on what the next move against Trump is, because Democrats are looking very foolish these days. Anyway, hey, you want to follow the Road to Ruta? Go to roadtoruta.com and join today. I'll talk to you guys later.